Alright, so here we are, downtown, in the belly of the beast. I'm about to go attend a protest. I brought some things with me. In this backpack, there's crackers and snacks. I've got some pretzels, some water. I also got a little bottle of hand sanitizer in there. I've also got some flags with me. We're gonna have fun with these later. And, yeah. So, in honor of George Floyd, or Gregory Floyd, apologize that I can't remember his first name, I will be partaking in a very important protest. From the looks of things and from what it sounds like, there probably won't be a lot of people there, but I'm still going to go anyways, and I'm going to go in front of the town hall, and it's going to be a good time. I'll keep you guys posted.
I can't breathe! I can't breathe!
Book, so we don't got no democracy no more.
Oh yeah.
You know they brought Bernie Sanders for the election, so burn it.
Oh, yeah, burn it. Fuck yeah, dude. It's about to go out too.
But I was busy yesterday. I was preoccupied with my cousins and I went to the lake.
I'm not gonna lie, these sort of events are very fun for me.
They really are.
I'm pretty sure it is. Yeah, like, even,
I mean, listen, man, like, I know this isn't really, like, strictly anti-capitalist. I know that it's just, you know, just people protesting the bullshit. But, I mean, a lot of these struggles are connected in more ways than people realize. Like, I mean, at the end of the day, like, these are, it's, there isn't just, like, black problems or, you know, gay problems or women's problems or white problems and whatnot. It's people's problems. Like, people in general have problems. And
I'm still debating about, are we in a depression or a recession?
No, it's a depression. It's definitely a depression.
They just don't want to say the D word, right?
Yeah. No, it is. We got, like, what, 20% unemployment? That's depression. Things are going to get a lot worse when people start running out of food. I mean, we already ran out of our stimulus checks, so, yeah. Hey, there's the cops. There they are. Piglets. There they are. Yeah. Freaking everybody's here, man. The Socialist Alternative, the DSA. I wonder where the PSL's at. They're probably too busy reading books. I don't see them out here anywhere. I thought these guys were supposed to be leading the vanguard or something.
You want to make yourself popular? Here's the press.
Oh, yeah. No, I've already talked to them. I've already been on Channel 9. Said what I was going to say. I don't know. I had to pick up my words on the spot.
Yeah, you want to fuck up.
Yeah.
National television.
No, I kind of did. Like, sometimes I get stage fright and I'll trip over my words. And it can be kind of stressful. But I feel like I said what I had to say.
What'd he say? Can you remember?
Well, he was just asking me some questions, you know, like...
How do you feel about the recession, like, economy?
How I feel about this protest. And I just told him it feels good to see people getting together, you know, to fight up against, you know, fight the power. Like, you know, this shit's gotta stop. We have a police system that, like, brutally represses people in this country nonstop. It's gotta come to a fucking end, dude. Like, and it isn't just black people either. White people are killed left and right by the cops too.
The media doesn't cover it.
It's not covered as much, but that's because it's disproportionately more heavy-handed towards black people. Like, black people are way over-policed, but I mean, really, all of us are. But it's just more so for the black community. And this is good because it raises attention to the problem. So, yeah. Makes me happy to see all these people here. We got a welcoming committee.
If we heard it, a natural disaster could happen like Katrina.
That's right.
These police officers ain't gonna help all damn body. They're gonna help their damn self and all family. Everybody on the foot, they see us. So that should tell you something. How you broke that your window last night.
That's right. That's just move on, motherfucker. Move on. Police keep coming by, man. They keep driving by. Like,
scared. They don't want that shit to blow up like they did in Minnesota. They burn that shit down to
the
street.
Oh, no, no. For every, like, we outnumber them by, like, an order of magnitude. Like, there's 10 of us for every one of them.
Because it's not even my script like that.
They're hiding in the parking garage over here, too.
Oh, yeah, no, they're hiding. They look like they're getting ready for an ambush. Hiding in the parking garage. No, what's happening is they're all waiting for someone to do something. That's what's probably gonna happen is you're gonna see some jacked dude who doesn't look like anybody here, who's like, you know, he's gonna come out, he's gonna be fully masked in disguise. He's gonna look, sound, walk, and act like a cop in every form. He's gonna throw a model off, and then that's gonna give him provocation to arrest everybody here. Well, watch out for the smashies. They will fuck up this protest. So, do you guys mind if I ask you some questions?
Sure.
Yeah. This is going on my channel. I won't film your faces if you don't want me to. That's why I've been pointing down this whole time. So, what made you guys want to come out here today?
Well, my daughter's mixed, so I want her to grow up in a better world.
You said what?
My daughter is mixed.
Your daughter's mixed?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So I want her to grow up in a better world than...
Oh, yeah.
She's got the fear for her life if she gets pulled over.
Oh, hell yeah, dude. Like, you know, my current significant other, she's black, and, I mean, she didn't want to come out today. I really tried to get her to come out, but, that's one of the reasons why I'm here. And, I mean, like, really, like, all of our struggles are the same struggle, you know? Like, when you see people getting beat down and suffered, really, in a way, that's kind of you that's, you know, suffering. So, like, we got to put a stop to it. It's got to come to an end, man. Are you part of any socialist parties at all? You should look into it sometime. There's a lot more struggle in the world to go around. And there's no struggle like the class struggle, my friend. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Let's be honest, the top 1% is built off of slavery, so that's why we live in a capitalist society and we never...
I mean, really, capitalism is just basically slavery with extra steps. It is. I mean, yeah, we industrialized, living standards improved it all, but at the end of the day, like, most people are, like, a paycheck away from eviction, you know?
Yeah. All walks of life here. So I feel like, let's abolish through the laws, get a clean slate, abolish
class society.
And all you're going is
right.
It's one of these people taking oath, like the Constitution, yet all rights are violated every day. Some of us in this crowd are older than black civil rights in America. How fucking sad is that? We've been fighting for how many years, and we still gotta be out here today. Because people don't realize that these people are disappearing. Those people are not living. All of these people are surrounding us right now. They are all present. Their job is to oppress us.
That's true.
When the nation realizes that these people have no duty to serve or protect,
all hell gonna break loose.
That's when we're gonna see a difference. Stop being afraid. That's what they count on. Every single day they roll through your neighborhood. Every single day they come in numbers and gang up on you, beat you up. No justice. Shoot you. No justice. Plant drugs. No justice. They give us high bonds knowing that we can't pay that shit.
Yeah. Criminalizing poverty, man, it's fucking ridiculous.
They want to give us a public defender that's going to surrender us right away. It's a trap. And these are the people who are going to deliver us through their trap. That's their job.
That's right.
They're all traitors. These people are terrorists. Terrorism works by invoking fear into the enemy to control and manipulate them. When you guys stop being scared, we gonna see a fucking difference. And don't let this momentum die after today. But if you want to stop after today,
Big Daddy Lord! Big Daddy Lord!
This video's gonna stop after today. Hell yeah! We all mad.
Hell yeah!
Right?
That's right!
Aren't you guys just tired of being mad with the same result?
Yeah!
Time to stand the fuck up.
And then they stand up. That's what they're doing, man. They're gentrifying. They're gentrifying this whole area and building these dumbass stadiums and projects that, like, nobody around here has money for. So they're gonna basically force everybody out. Yep. It's already happening. It's on some streets. Waste of our tax money. They are pissing away our tax dollar right there. Pissing it away. Pissing it the fuck away!
jacking up the rent, kicking all these people out so they can bring in people with money to pay for their dumbass commodity shit.
All right, we're taking the highway. Someone got hurt back there. I hope they're doing all right, but yeah, we're about to block a highway. Okay, so the police are down there. The police are coming. Everybody's on the highway. Fucking hell.
Stop bump sats. Fuck it.
Fuck yeah. So I'd say this is going pretty well. We have blocked the highway. There's at least 900 people behind me.
We didn't block that one.
But we blocked the highway. They actually shut down the highway. And we're still fucking marching. Pretty sweet. If I do say so myself. Tell you what though, I got work at 1 in the morning. I'm not going to be able to stick around for that much longer. God damn. There are so many people here.
Let's keep going!
Highway to the courthouse!
We talked the crowd into taking the highway back. We shut down the highway successfully, so we're gonna march all the way down the highway back to the courthouse, and we'll be done with our little demonstration here. Flying their little drone. Hey. So we crossed the highway. Pretty lit. Blocking both sides of the highway. Fuck yeah. Alright, I'm about to hop over. We will be back momentarily.
I can't breathe!
There's a dude here who pulled a gun out of his car.
If we make it to CNN news, that'd be damaged.
Oh yeah, check this out. There's so many people here, holy shit.
That's what I'm saying, that's all proof. What
isn't the Starship Troopers.
Starship! They finally got the troopers out now.
Yep, Starship Troopers, here we are.
In the case of NWA versus the police department, prosecuting attorneys are.
Oh man, that's a bomb waiting to happen. That's great, that's all. Oh yeah, they're following us. Well, this has been a pretty eventful night. Hope you guys enjoyed what you watched. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'm gonna have more to say about this topic in the future. Peace out.